Dewan says, which by the way, Dewan joined the mastermind after last week's Hump Day Hangout. And so we appreciate you, Dewan, joining. And he's got a lot of good questions in there already. And we've got a mastermind webinar tomorrow. And we're actually going to dive into some of the stuff that he was asking about in there. So welcome, Dewan, once again. And we've got some stuff we're going to cover for you tomorrow during the mastermind webinar. He says, when you say you send traffic to Appease Google, do you mean like Crowdsearch alternative? And no, Dewan, I know you directed this at Margo, so I'll let Marco add to this as well. But as we were just saying, it's not about spoofed traffic. You could probably still get results with some spoofed traffic. However, we're talking about relevant traffic, right? Just the same as we don't, it's funny, you know, we don't do a lot of PBN stuff, and we don't do domain authority manipulation anymore because it's just, we found it's more about relevancy. Like that's the longer term, that's the better strategy. And so we try to do everything. Now, I say that, and I just was talking about spam links, like our service for spam links in MGYB. It works really well if you know what to point it at, which is an example of like what we were talking about with DriveStacks or, you know, Amazon S3 hosted pages. Those kind of things are incredibly, if you know how to use spam properly, you can get results from even like traditional spam type links, right? But it's not something that we would ever want to point directly at a money site. Well, the same thing goes for traffic signals, right? You can buy spam traffic signals or spoof traffic signals using an app like Crowdsearch, which by the way, used to be incredibly effective. We promoted the shit out of it for about 2 years because I used it. I mean, a lot. I used it a lot. I was using 50,000 credits a month with that thing. And it worked really, really well. But Google's algorithm learned not to count that kind of traffic. And there's a number of reasons why it became less effective and started having diminishing returns. And I'm not going to get into all of that. We can talk about that in the mastermind webinar if you'd like, Dewan. But so spam traffic signals can still produce some results, but they're marginal at best compared to if you can buy or send relevant traffic signals, which is the same thing that we're talking about. Like, for example, you know, even traditional SEO, like link building stuff, we can create or add relevancy even to spam links by sending spam links to a drive stack that is 100% relevant. And it uses the Google domain to help kind of launder that negative link juice. Well, the same thing goes with traffic signals, right? If you can force or push real traffic into your digital assets, your entities, so to speak, right? Your brand entities from either referral sources or even buying it direct. If it's relevant traffic, that traffic is going to be weighted so much heavier by Google, right? So for SEO purposes, relevant traffic is weighted much heavier than non-relevant traffic. So for example, if you were to send hundreds of visitors to a blog post on your site that aren't engaging with it, but it's just the visitor hits, right? That you're trying to send traffic signals to it. Can that help? Yes, it may be able to help. It may be able to give you a small boost in the ranks or even a big boost. But the problem is when you stop sending that traffic, what happens? It'll start to slip again because those weren't sustainable signals. But if you can send a fraction of relevant traffic signals from an audience that Google is fully aware of is already interested in that topic or that content. And how do they do that? Well, if you're buying traffic from Google, you can buy traffic from known audiences, right? You can buy traffic from Google directly from YouTube or directly from Display Network or search ads if you wanted. It's crazy expensive, but from, let's say, Display Network or from YouTube, where you can literally select the audiences that you want Google to display your ads to, right? Or expose your ads to. So Google knows that those people are already interested in that topic. So Google knows that those people are relevant. And because they're relevant, when you send those traffic signals to, or those that traffic, excuse me, to your content, they're likely to engage with it. And the engagement signals are more powerful than just bare traffic signals, if that makes sense. Which means they not only will the traffic and engagement help the SEO, but it's likely that you're going to actually convert some of that traffic into whatever your conversion goal may be, whether that's opting in to build your email list, or if it's for local business, it's making a phone call, becoming a lead, or submitting a contact request form. Or if it's a straight like e-com, you're trying to sell something, they may purchase your products. So instead of trying to put your effort, time, and money into spoofing traffic, why not put your effort, time, and money into buying relevant traffic or generating relevant traffic through social engineering, or as Marco calls it, social conditioning? Again, you're going to get much better results with a fraction of the numbers required that you would from spoofing stuff, by just sending relevant traffic signals and engagement from real people that have a real genuine interest in your topic or your content, your product, your service, whatever it may be. Mark, you want to add to that?
Yeah, what I want to add is there's something really simple, and Google is starting to get even smarter because they boiled it down, right? And I call it the art of art: activity, relevance, trust, and authority. And it's at the link origin and link destination, and everything attached to the link origin and the link destination. So Google is looking at the activity on the links, meaning how are people interacting with the website that's feeding you the link, and how are they interacting when they get to the destination of the link. Activity, relevance. Well, is it relevant? Did they come from women's shoes and end up at I don't know, bricks? Absolutely nothing. One to do with the other. It has to be relevant. And it has to be trusted and authoritative. That's why we love being inside the belly of the beast, being inside Google. So if you can get those three things, Dewan or Dewan, Dewan, I'm not sure how that's pronounced, but either way, let me know. We'll be on the mastermind. Tell me how it's pronounced. Get art in there. Now, it's very difficult, as far as the activity is concerned, to get purchase traffic. And I'm talking about Fiverr. I'm talking about traffic exchanges and all these other places, to get these people to act like real people, even if you're in a traffic exchange with real people. Because in a traffic exchange, all the people are concerned about is earning more whatever tokens or whatever credits so that they can get more traffic to their own properties. They're not interested in dwelling on your website. They're not interested in interacting with your website. And Google is looking at all of these things. So how can you get, and think of it, how can you get that activity? How can you get that real person to act like a real person? Well, you buy real people. You either train them the right way, or you pay Google and Facebook and Instagram and whatever else to send the right people wherever you want it to go. They don't have to go to your money site. They can go into your link stream and end up at the money site. Now, here's the key thing and the great thing. Fiverr traffic does work. And the way that I've gotten it to work is you have to get in with like a real conversation with the provider, so that the provider knows exactly what it is that you're looking for. And they have to be able to tell you, yes, I can do it, or no, I can't. And then you test it. Even if they tell you, oh, yeah, I can do that. I can do that. I can get local IPs and I can get traffic to go in there like that. You test it. You never test on anything that's going to make you money. Although you set it up as if you're going to make money with your test. And you should. Now, once you have that and you get all of these real people interacting and you see how it works and how Google reacts to this traffic, then you know that you can trust this guy. Never lose that Fiverr contact, because it's worth gold. Three or four people out at tier two, tier three, tier four, interacting with your links and ending up at the destination wherever you want and finishing whatever it is that you set them to do. That's what Google wants to see: the completion of that original action at the destination. So that's the key. And if you're doing that, if you're buying from Fiverr or anything, is that just going in and paying just whatever for whoever for whatever? It's actually, you have to know and understand what it is that Google is looking for so that you can buy and try to approximate what Google is looking for.